Hey, it's spooky season, and around here that means a few things. Pumpkins, trick or treat, and most importantly, Instagram. So last Halloween, we had a really great time making our spider-faced arachne filter, and this year we decided we wanted to do something a little more along the lines of a classic Hollywood monster. And we also knew we wanted to try out some of the newer features that have been added. So we put our heads together and came up with what we thought was a really fun idea based around Frankenstein's monster. So we're working with Spark AR Studio, a tool from Facebook, which is made specifically for the kind of small-scale augmented reality experiences that are perfect to be published on platforms like Facebook and Instagram. So when you're making a face filter in Spark AR, the basic component is this face tracker, which accurately detects the position of facial features and can even detect facial expressions. Once the tracker's in position, it's then a case of working out the different assets that you want to attach to the tracker in order to achieve the look that you want. Really, that's where the fun starts.
Spark AR comes with a set of default assets, which contains a 3D model of a standard face and a texture for it. And you can do all sorts of manipulations to change the filter according to your needs. Once the base mesh is imported into the sculpting program, I can carve in the details to make the face look like a scarred and the lightest affects the stitches. I also did some minor tweaks to the facial structure to create some hollow cheeks, some more pronounced eyebrows that's so characteristic of the monster. In this case, these changes were fairly subtle, but you can tweak it more to get a more pronounced effect. The software comes with a really artist-friendly interface to do some basic programming. If you don't know any coding, you can still just use a couple of nodes and connect them up together.
So there's a lot of possibilities with Spark AR. We're using it to publish to Instagram in this instance, but you can publish to other platforms too. The node-based system allows you to build up some really complex and interesting interactions, and the constant support from Facebook means there's new features being added all the time. To try the filter for yourself, head on over to our Instagram profile and hit that smiley face icon in the middle. I'll drop a link somewhere in the description below. And don't forget to tag us, we can see your scary faces. And if you want to talk to us about making an Instagram filter, then get in touch by email or drop us a message. If you want to stay in touch with other things we're up to in the studio, follow and subscribe.